Now, class, our fourth topic is why compass needle deflects when it is placed near a current carrying wire. Okay, so we have just studied near a current carrying wire. We can also write near current carrying wire. Okay, so suppose we are having a wire which is carrying current in upward direction, and the current has been represented by letter capital I. Now we have just studied compass needle. The darker end is north pole and the lighter end is north south pole. Now the moment we place this magnet, this compass needle, near the current carrying wire, so they have asked the question, what will we observe for the first time? What is happening to the compass needle? This is the question. Now before that, I'll draw one more thing. Just wait. Now we have just studied ki when we are using a bar magnet, then the magnetic lines will originate from north pole and they will end at south pole, and inside the magnet they will move from south to north. So so if I ask you a question ki is it only bar magnet or a natural magnet can produce magnetic lines of force? No. Now this is a very important topic. Even a current carrying wire can act as a magnet. Why? Because a current carrying wire can also produce what? Magnetic lines of force. This we are studying. This is our observation. You cannot name it, you just have to observe it, you just have to memorize it ki if there is a current in a wire, then it will be having magnetic lines of force. And what will be the shape and direction, that I am telling you. Okay, so suppose we are having a straight conducting wire, say of copper, and we are having current in upward direction. Now it will be having magnetic lines of force. It will be acting as a magnet. Now why it is acting as a magnet? Because it is giving out magnetic lines of force. So what will be the symmetry? That can be judged with the help of a simple rule I am telling you. This is called right hand grip rule. This is called right hand grip rule. Right hand grip rule. Okay. Right hand thumb rule, you can also call it. So suppose, and so what does this rule say? Point your thumb in the direction of current and then curl your fingers. Curl your fingers. So my fingers are curling in this direction. So magnetic lines of force are moving from this direction and they are coming outward and they are going inward. Now suppose this is wire. So magnetic lines are coming out of the plane. Out of the plane is represented by this symbol. Out of the plane. And they and here they are going into the plane. So these are the two symbols. So whenever in coming lectures I'll be drawing this. This means magnetic lines of force are coming out of the plane. And if I'm drawing cross, which means magnetic lines of force are going into the plane. So and all the magnetic lines of force are in the shape of concentric circles. Okay, concentric circles. So we have studied even a current carrying wire can act as a magnet, but it is not a magnet, because once the current is zero, all these magnetic lines of force will disappear. So a current carrying wire can act as a magnetic source, and the magnetic lines of force are in the shape of concentric circles, and the direction is given by right hand grip rule. Now what does this rule says? Point your thumb in the direction of current and curl your fingers, then the curling of fingers will give the direction of magnetic lines of force. Okay. Now class, you can see I have reversed the direction of current. Now the current is going in downward direction. Now we want to determine the new direction of magnetic lines of force. Shape will be same. It will be again concentric circles, but we want to determine the direction. Again, the current is going in downward direction. So point your thumb in the direction of current and curl your fingers. Now fingers are going into the plane. So into the plane. This symbol is for into the plane. And from this side, it is coming out of the plane. Out of the plane. Again, I'm telling you, suppose this is current, this is wire. So current is going in downward direction. So you curl your fingers. So in this half, the magnetic lines of force are into the plane, and in this half they are coming out of the plane. So we have learnt one thing. A current carrying wire can act as a magnetic source. Yes, it can give out magnetic lines of force. Yes. What is the shape of magnetic lines of force? Concentric circles. And on reversing the current, the direction of magnetic lines of force also reverses. So class, you can note down this point under this heading. On reversing direction of current, direction of magnetic lines of force also reverses. In what? Current carrying wire. Current carrying wire. So we have completed this topic. I hope you got the topic. Okay class, so we have just studied ki a current carrying wire can also act as a magnet, and it will give out magnetic lines of force in the shape of concentric circles. Now the question is, the activity was ki what happens when you place a compass needle near a current carrying wire. So suppose this is north pole and this is south pole, and suppose this is north pole and this is south pole. So once you switch on the current, once the current is on, once the current is passing through the wire, the magnetic compass will deflect like this. You can see it will align itself in this direction. Why it is aligning? Because see, here it is going out of the plane. Out of the plane is represented by this, and here magnetic lines of force are going into the plane. Now it is the property of a magnet to align its north pole in the direction of magnetic lines of force. This is the natural property. Now you will ask, sir, why? There is no explanation of this. This is only an observation. See, suppose if I give an example, if I take an object and if I leave it, it will fall downward. It is due to gravity. It is the natural tendency. In the same way, if I am leaving a compass needle near a current carrying wire, so the north pole will align itself in the direction of, in the direction of what? Magnetic lines of force. So it will become like this. So I cannot draw this in the figure. So this is like this. So what is the observation? Yes, compass needle will show deflection once the current is passing through a straight current carrying wire. And the deflection of this compass needle is due to the magnetic lines of force of this compass needle. Okay. Got my point? Okay. So this is the property of every magnet. Even if a normal magnet is placed, suppose I'm putting a normal magnet like this. Suppose south is here and north is here. Okay. So again, it will deflect like this. Okay. So whenever you are asked ki why a compass needle deflects when it is placed near a current carrying wire, you will say because the north pole of magnet always try to align itself in the direction of magnetic lines of force, due to which it gets deflected. So this is the note you can write under this heading. North pole of a magnet always aligns itself in the direction of magnetic lines of force. And this is due to the reason ki every compass needle or magnet will show deflection in the presence of current carrying wire.